everybody, Mattias here. Today I'm going to showcase you some of the new features of Bitwig Studio 4. We're going to look at the features like comping and the new note operators, or conditional triggers, if you will. And of course we're going to do a test project on the MacBook Pro with the Apple Silicon M1 CPU. And as icing on the cake, I can finally reveal that I'm working on a Bitwig Studio Masterclass. And make sure you sign up your interest to the Masterclass today, because everybody who signs up to the Masterclass and also enters into the Masterclass when it finally goes live will receive a free 25 euro producer essentials pack with tons of presets for Bitwig Studio. Right, so now let's take the tour in Bitwig Studio 4. Right, so let's begin by talking about the note operators in our demo project here in Bitwig 4. You can find the note operators if you click a MIDI clip. We can select this hi-hat clip in our project. And if you select any one or many of these note events, you will find the operators on the information panel at the left side here. So what are note operators in Bitwig Studio 4? Note operators is basically conditional triggers. And that means that you can program certain conditions on your note events. And those note events will only trigger or sound when these conditions are fulfilled. And like I mentioned in the introduction, conditional triggers is something that you would find on something like the Digitakt or the Analog 4. And now it's found its way into Bitwig Studio. That said, the conditional triggers or the operators in Bitwig Studio is a little bit more powerful. First, you have the chance operator, and that's basically like rolling a dice. Bitwig will play the event if the dice is less or equal to the percentage. And if you open up the note expression here, you can see that we have the chance expression available. And you can also see and set the actual percentage here in the information panel. So we can maybe set this note to only trigger 50% of the time. So let's do the same thing to these other notes. Set them to 50%. And now these note events will only trigger 50% of the time. So the chance function can definitely induce a little bit of randomization and make your beats a little bit more organic if you want to have that kind of variation into the beats. The second operator is the repeat operator. And this one is crucial if you're making trap beats. And we can select a note event here in our little beat and look at this second event, the repeat event. Notice that I can deactivate or mute some of these operators. Now you can see this, the repeat counter is off at the moment, but if we drag upwards or downwards, we can set the repetition amount for this note event. So let's say that this event will repeat 6 times. We can also offset the repeats, so we can have a different repeat curve. So maybe they will be faster at the end and slower in the beginning, like this. Let's listen how that sounds. Maybe have a repetition in the beginning here. Select this event, drag upwards in the repeater here. Okay, so now it's a good time to look at the third operator, the occurrence operator. And that's the if operator here. So if we press this mixed button here, you can see that we have a different conditions here. You can always, which will play this note unconditionally, or you can set it to only play on the first cycle, if this is a cyclic loop. And you can also play it if the last event played. So that means if you have a note event before this note event, this event will only play if the previous event was playing. So you have quite a few different programmatic options to set here. But the one we will look at in this video is the fill. So let's activate fill on. And that means that this note event will play when the fill mode is on in Bitwig Studio. And you activate the fill mode with this fill button up here. Notice that you have this fill icon, the little plus sign here, on some of the events in the drum beat here. And when we play back this piece and we activate the fill button, these note events with the plus sign will also play. So if you're doing a live DJ jam with Bitwig Studio, this can be a great way to induce fills or to induce variation in your live performance. So as you can see, if we mix the repeat with the occurrence operator in Bitwig Studio, it's very easy to create these variations in your trap beats. Right, so let's look at the final operator, the recurrence operator. So say that we have a little arpeggio loop like this. And now let's loop this little MIDI clip. So we selected the bottom area here and drag this all the way to the final section here. Now this arpeggio will loop throughout this whole section. But maybe we only want to hear those rapid notes at the end of this phrase, only every second bar. So let's select this area of the more rapid notes here and go to recurrence and drag upwards. So you can set these to 4 bars. And now we will only activate the first one here. And if we zoom in a little bit more, you can actually see this recurrence operator actively on the note events. But let's say they will only play on the first bar in a 4-bar section. So you can activate them on every second bar like this. So that's also a very nice operator to induce a variation to your beats very quickly. And it can be a great way to experiment with your beats or your patterns to find the new variations. And if you want, you can even set this to 5 bars, which will make this kind of polyrhythmic in a way. Okay, so that's the operators in Bitwig 4, and I think it's a nice way to induce randomization into your beats. So the operators is probably something you will use in a live situation in your performance. Let's talk about the comping in Bitwig Studio 4, because we finally have the ability to record multiple takes and then afterwards mix and match between these different takes to make our final master take. To activate comping and recording takes in Bitwig Studio 4, you go up here and activate this record as comping takes, and also make sure that you have overdub activated if you want to record in the arranger. It's also nice to have the option to record the comping takes into the clip launcher. So just activate overdub in the clip launcher and press the record as comping takes. Now let's record some comping takes with the acoustic. Okay, so now we can see all my recordings here in one single view as different recording takes. And make sure you're in the clip view of your audio clip, because that's where the comping resides. Now we can just click one of these takes and we can listen to that specific take. Let's listen to take 4. And now you can also mix and match this. I don't typically use comping myself. I rather record single takes, but for the sake of this video, let's do a little bit of editing here. Of course, recording takes can be very time-saving if you just want to press play, record, and then improvise your solos or rhythms. Right, there's also some more creative ways that you can use comping. So let's create a new audio track here and find a loop. And the initial loop sounds like this. So the loop is already cut up and quite intriguing, but we can actually make it even more insane. So let's just right click here and select fold to takes. And this way we can break apart the loop and create different takes from it. So let's say we want, let's create four takes. So now we have effectively broken apart this loop into four different lanes here. And now we can mix and match these. Like this. Just make sure we're on the grid up here, so it's tied to the beat. And a little bit of this and a little bit of that. Maybe we want another ending. So that's one way that you can use this new comping functionality to break apart your loop library and create the more intriguing loops. Okay, so we had a look at the comping feature of Bitwig Studio 4. Now let's continue and try to export this song, because we now have the ability to export to MP3 and the Opus format. So let's use the shortcut here and press Command, Shift and B to open up our export window. And here we have the regular wave export, where you can set your bitrate, but you also have the ability to set Ogg Vorbis and MP3, finally. I know this is a huge time saver for everyone, because you don't want to spend time jumping between different applications just to convert your wave files into MP3s. So I'm really glad we finally get this export feature to MP3 in Bitwig Studio. Okay, so let's talk about the exciting new Apple Silicon M1 technology. Because Bitwig Studio 4 is now fully compatible with the Apple M1 CPU. With the flexible plugin support in Bitwig, it basically runs the DAW and the plugin separately, so you can safely run native ARM64 plugins, which is the new Apple M1 technology, and the Intel-based VSTs alongside each other. And if a plugin does crash, Bitwig Studio keeps running and you can just safely restart and replace the plugin that crashed. I've already done plenty of videos and articles on the new Apple M1, but if you want to check out one of those videos, you can click the card up here. So this is the same product as we saw earlier, and if I open up the DSP graph here, we can see the performance. And you can see we have plenty of room to add more plugins and sounds to this project before hitting the wall, so to speak. And if you open up the activity monitor on OS X, you can actually see that we have a Bitwig Studio running at 43% CPU. Keep in mind that I'm running OBS here on the same Apple M1 MacBook Pro, and you can see it eats quite a lot of CPU. But we can also see that the Bitwig Studio plugin host is loaded as X64, and that's an Intel application, so that's the older technology translated to the new ARM64 code, and that's to confirm that we can run the native ARM64 plugins alongside these Intel-based VSTs. So you can see the product just runs fine here on the Apple M1 MacBook Pro. And this is the 13-inch model with 8 GB of RAM, and I mentioned that in some previous video that 8 GB on the new Apple M1 technology is definitely enough for basic music production. The new M1 technology isn't really comparable to the older generation, because On the M1 chips you have basically the memory in the same package as the CPU. So you have a very speedy access between the memory and the CPU. Right, so is there something missing in Bitwig Studio 4? Yes, I would really really have liked to have video support in Bitwig Studio 4. I mean, everybody is making short films, everybody is making films these days, everybody's making TikToks, YouTubes, whatever. So we need video support in Bitwig Studio, because in all the major DAWs you have video support. So I really hope that the Bitwig developers takes this seriously and implements video support in a nearby release. That said, I really like this new release with the comping and the operators, and especially that MP3 export function. Okay, so if you don't have Bitwig Studio, you can grab Bitwig Studio via my affiliate link in the description to this video, and there's also a discount code so you get a 10% discount on your purchase. And finally, don't forget to sign up to my Bitwig Studio Masterclass, which will launch sometime in September. Right, if you're new to my channel, be sure to subscribe, hit the like and the notification bell so that you get a notice as soon as I release new videos. My name is Mattias, see you in the next video, bye!